the Bren Center in Irvine for a SoCal showdown in the OC. New look LMU enters this season pretty much unknown. The Lions graduated nearly their entire starting five from a year ago when they were last in the West Coast Conference. As for UC Irvine, they may have some of the highest expectations a Big West team has had in years. The Anteaters saw their tourney run end on the final possession against Louisville last March, and with their core back for another campaign, excitement at an all-time high in Orange County. Welcome, everybody. I'm Trent Schlum. Next to me is Rob Abreu and the coach, Bill Vano, former UNLV head coach, also a longtime NBA assistant. And Rob, I want to ask you first about the style in this matchup tonight. UC Irvine, one of those teams, they like to slow it down, use their size. As far as LMU goes, they are helter-skelter all over the place.
Well, with LMU, we really don't know what we have yet. Tons of transfers on their team, but they're led by senior Marin Mornar, who had 10 points in the opener, 50% all-time career field goal percentage. But keep your eye out for National Junior College Player of the Year, Brandon Brown.
Yeah, they have a lot of impact transfers on this team. And Bill, you know big man better than just about anybody else when it comes to knowing elite basketball players. How do you see Mamadou Ndiaye when it comes to his potential for the NBA?
You know, I had the pleasure to coach Mamadou at the Adidas Nations College Counselor Camp last year, and he's a definite NBA prospect. Anytime you're 7'6" and you can catch the ball, he's got good hands. And, you know, in the NBA now, the GMs and coaches alike are putting a premium on rim protection. He gives you that. I spoke to Russell Turner. The areas he has to get better at, you know, with his foot speed and his mobility. Russell said he's made progress. He's working hard with the strength coach. And I'd venture to say the entire NBA will be down here at some point to get a look at him. And I think he's got a chance.
All eyes on Mamadou tonight. It's a WCC Big West battle this evening on the opening weekend of college hoops. LMU and UCI starters will tip off when we return on KDOC.
Never before has performance sounded so revolutionary. Watch the big finish of The Hunger Games, Mockingjay Part 2, November 20th. Get revved up with 0% APR for 75 months on select 2015 Dodge Chargers at the Black Friday Blockbuster Sales Event on Now. California residents now get 0% APR for 75 months plus 2,000 total bonus cash on the 2015 Dodge Charger RT.
We at Time Warner Cable need to apologize to you. We no longer offer extended periods of free on-hold elevator music when you call us.
We're making a bunch of changes to Time Warner Cable, including reducing how long you could wait on hold. Now we'll even call you back at a time that's convenient for you.
But for those of you who'd miss our old on-hold music, please check out our greatest hits at twc.com/onholdhits.
Kraft is alive and currently on display in your derby car. Correction, your son's derby car. The rules clearly stipulate this is a chance for fifth graders to shine, not you. But even stand-in craftsmen deserve a well-crafted reward. At BJ's Restaurant and Brewhouse, we believe people don't go out for good. They go out for great. Because the best times aren't made, they're crafted. Get $10 off $35. Visit BJsRestaurants.com for more details.
This UCI basketball game on KDOC TV Los Angeles is brought to you by Time Warner Cable. Enjoy better. And your Southern California Chevy dealers and the Black Friday sale, going on now all month long at your Southern California Chevy dealers. And Tough Shed, we're more than great sheds.
Loyola Marymount at UC Irvine College Hoops on KDOC. I'm Trent Schlum with Bill Bano. Let's meet starters from Loyola Marymount. We know Amanis Tutu, Brandon Brown. We know a great transfer, Peter Herman. Stephen Haney, somebody that we didn't get to mention in the open. He's a transfer from Central Florida, an outstanding three-point shooter. And Shamar Johnson, head coach Mike Dunlap for LMU in his second year. Was 8-23 last season. The Lions at the bottom of West Coast Conference standings, comes over from the Bobcats, part of a great coaching tree. Lute Olson, George Carl, Ernie Cantley was at Oregon, Steve Lavin at St. John's. For UC Irvine, notable starters will be Alex Young, Luke Nelson, Dominic Dunning, Mike Best, and the big fella Mamadou Ndiaye. pretty much their returners from a year ago, three of the five starters from a team that won the Big West last season, went to the NCAA tournament for the first time in school history. For UC Irvine, we know who they are. Pretty much the same group that came back from last season. It's a whole different story for Loyola Marymount as we are ready to begin this game. Russell Turner, the head coach for UCI in his sixth year with the Anteaters, opening tip controlled, will go to LMU. Mamadou got all of that one, but it goes out of bounds. LMU is in maroon. UC Irvine in their home goals. That's Brandon Brown with it now. Gives it over 2-2.
UCI comes out man-to-man.
That's 2-2. 12 on the shot clock. They go inside to Johnson. Goes with the right hand, swatted away by Mamadou.
You already see the presence of N'Jai Johnson hesitated on the original shot.
Billy, you just see right there what Mamadou changes the game defensively as teams can't go inside.
Yeah, especially at this level. They're not used to seeing that type of height or length. They're fronting them in the post.
Pass from the free throw line is good. 2-0 UCI. Blocked from behind by Young. Luke Nelson picks it up, goes inside, back to Best for two.
Quick start for Best, 4 points to start.
Mike Best, the senior, came off the bench a year ago and stepped up for Will Davis, who graduated. That three way off the mark by Haney. And this is a guy that has the green light all night long.
Yeah, shaky start for the Lions offense.
That shot looked good, though. He had good form on it.
Splashdown for Alex Young, a 7-0 run for the Anteaters to begin this game. Both teams come into tonight 1-0 on the season. UC Irvine beat UC San Diego on Friday night. LMU beat Cal State Fullerton. Both those teams played at home. Johnson tries to get Mamadou to face up. Poked away. Dunning with the right hand, no.
LMU testing Mamadou early, but coming back with negative results.
They had him up in the air that time. They just couldn't make the play. Good shot fake by Johnson.
You see Irvine very active in the passing lanes so far in this game.
And when you have a big man like Mamadou protecting the basket, you can afford to be aggressive and pressure the lanes.
Absolutely.
2-2 with it. Guarded by Nelson. 7 on the shot clock. Brandon Brown and an offensive foul against LMU. Goes against Johnson his first with the illegal screen.
Johnson struggled in the opener, had 12 minutes, 5 fouls, already has one here tonight.
LMU, one of those teams that likes to play very aggressively. They'll
Here's
test
the zone.
The officials.
Zone press.
Long pass nearly taken away by Herman. He is able to break it up. LMU will bring in a sub and Adam Jacko, that is, who was huge on their opening night. 22 points, 10 boards, 6 of those rebounds on the offensive glass.
And that first possession press turned into a turnover. It's a good sign for LMU. That might change the tempo here for him, give him a little confidence.
UCI out to a quick 7-0 lead. Couple buckets by Best. Young hit a three. That's Jacko, who shoots over Mamadou and scores.
And already, you already see the offensive difference between Jacko and Johnson as Jacko turns around, faces up, and hits the shot right over N'Jai.
And Rob, they went right at him as soon as he got in the game. First touch, I like that, confidence.
They are not shying away from Mamadou at all.
Well, that's one thing we like about Jacko is he has that very strong mid-range jumper, really stretches out at defense.
Big basket for LMU to break the ice. Maybe they'll settle down. Let's see.
They go to Best, who goes hard inside. Jacko That deflecting goes off the Heasy.
Telling you what, Jacko's already made a difference in his first two possessions. Got the first bucket and there with the block on Best.
Jacko, one of the top junior college players in California a year ago. Three ball by 2-2 off the front of the iron. Njai secures the rebound. Nelson in transition, no.
Boy, LMU dodged a bullet there. Can't have Nelson that wide open on a break.
Nelson, a preseason all-conference selection in the Big West.
You got a piece of that.
Jacko can't get that one.
It's Njai's length. He could afford to shadow off 2 to 3 feet, still get some of that basketball.
Yeah, he got a piece of that ball. Another three.
Nelson misses this one.
Nelson really stepped into that one.
And then gets the steal on the other end. 2-on-1. Mamadou inside. Huge mismatch. And the slam! Mamadou bringing the house down at the Bren. Timeout on the floor. It's 9-2. UC Irvine. Oh, Mamadou.
This is Black Friday.
Oh my God!
Does anybody want to be part of this?
No.
Well, Chevy has a better way. With Black Friday deals all month long.
That's a great idea.
What if you could get up to 20% cash back when you bought it?
Bam!
20% back? Awesome.
It's Black Friday. Find your tag and get cash back for 20% of the MSRP on select 2015 vehicles in stock. Or get 0% financing for 72 months on 2015 Silverado light duty models.
Find new roads at your Southern California Chevy dealers.
Are you ready for changing weather? Make your life easier with the ultimate winterizing accessory, a Tough Shed storage building or garage. Not all sheds are created equal. Protect your belongings with the only buildings durable and secure enough to earn the Tough Shed name. For smashing year-end deals on the best storage buildings and garages, there's only one place to look, Tough Shed. 7 factory direct locations to serve you. Call 1-800-BUY-TOUGH for the store nearest you and visit us online at toughshed.com.
I think you're going soft. I mean, when was the last time you tried to blow something up or take over the world or even use the phrase, damn you?
Hey, I got a lot on my plate, man. I'm learning to use the toilet. I'm learning what shapes are. I spent half an hour laughing at my own feet yesterday.
Yeah, you're losing it, man. You're losing your edge.
Well, I don't care for your tone, and I'd say you deserve a good kick. Look at them.
Family Guy, weeknights at 10 and 10:30 on KDOC-TV, Los Angeles. Do fun.
There's Mike Dunlap, the head coach for LMU. Those are some NBA experience and coach the Bobcats before coming to his alma mater at Loyola Marymount. Has had to deal with a brand new team, a complete overhaul of the roster from a year ago. And we've seen some of that lack of continuity so far. That really until Autumn Jacko came in, though.
Yeah, clearly UCI has the more experienced team, and they were poised and ran their offense. And LMU, understandably, had a little bit of deer in the headlights. Let's see if they can get a little confidence off of Jacko's basket and get settled here.
Brandon Smith comes in for Dominic Dunning for UC Irvine. Mamadou stays in the game. One thing we saw with Mamadou last year, never played a whole lot of minutes on long runs like this. He'll play at least 5 minutes right now, and that's big for the big fella.
Another tough contested shot by LMU.
There's Jaron Martin also into the game for the first time. No Aaron Wright tonight for UCI. You missed their opener as well against UC San Diego.
Herman aggressive on the show there. Left Njai.
But an offensive foul goes against Brandon Smith, a freshman that they're very high on here at UCI.
You're right, Rob. They're out showing, but I like it because they're impacting the ball, and those guards are pretty good, and they'll get weak side tags on Mamadou. I like that pressure on the ball screens by the bigs.
They're going to have to take some risks tonight.
Yeah, for sure, for sure. Got to get some offensive flow.
Brandon Brown to bring it up. That's Mornar. Guarded by Best. LMU, pretty slow start for the Lions. There's a foul against Irvine.
Rob, you mentioned it pregame. I'm surprised Brandon isn't being more aggressive. You know, he obviously can get to where he wants to go, but he hasn't taken a shot yet. He's their leading scorer.
Yeah, well, he had that one play coming off the pick and roll that got blocked by Young from behind, but Njai was in his face too. I think that might be affecting him mentally.
Guys, so far we're seeing LMU having to play UCI style as Jacko hits that one, his first bucket.
Jacko building momentum off that impressive first game against Cal State Fullerton.
It's 9-4, Irvine over Jacko. He's got all their baskets.
Another aggressive show, almost caused a turnover.
It's Marmon split two, Marmon. They bring him high for the pick, misses the shot. Marmon tries to get the slam, gets hit hard. And Njai will go to the free throw line.
And right there, Bill, we saw what you pay the price for that aggressive show. Njai gets the offensive rebound.
Yeah, and you know, you got to give Alex Young credit. He rejected the screen. He didn't use the screen, and that's a, you know, an NBA option when teams are showing. If you can reject the screen, there's no big defender there, and he had a clear run to the rim, and it opened up an offensive rebound for the big fella.
That's the second against Haney. Mamadou hits the first free throw.
Tell you, that's a plus in the eyes of the NBA when your big guys can make free throws and his form looks good. That was a nice looking shot.
Njai, 52% free throw shooter last year. But he's got a nice stroke, better I think than what maybe that statistic shows.
Yeah, and he's probably worked on it. And that was good too, in and out, looked good.
Brown, bring it up.
Martin's just playing great defense on Brown right now.
Yep, you got to give him credit.
Seven on the shot clock. Tough shot by Brown, no. Offensive rebound, Jacko. He puts that one up short. Rebound, Momadou.
I thought Brown forced that one a little bit. He had Jacko on the pick and pop, but decided to force up the fadeaway.
Absolutely. And then Jacko followed that with a tough contested two. You're not going to win playing that way.
Galloway comes in, another young player. Irvine staff very high on. There is Smith in and out. Pump free, picked up by Brown. Here's Brown in transition.
Great defense.
That was an opportunity right there for the Lions. Njai trailing the play, an opportunity to get to the basket. They were unable to do so.
No question, LMU, one of those teams they like to get out and run. Shot by Torch, missed. Jump ball, possession arrow. Famers the Anteaters.
All things considered, this could be worse. I mean, they haven't made a shot. They're only down, 6 points. If they can hang in there, they got to get some offensive continuity from somebody.
And now Njai coming out of the game. This is a great opportunity for LMU to attack the basket.
UC Irvine does bring in another 7-footer in Giannis Dimakopoulos. 7'2", but not nearly the kind of strength and muscle you see from Momadou. There's a 2-on-1. Smith, yes.
The beautiful jump to avoid the charge by Smith.
Spears hits it on the other end. Transition three for LMU. That's their style of play.
Allows them to set up the press as well.
Hopefully that gets LMU going. That's a big shot.
Nelson on the other side, no. Goes off the hands of Galloway. It'll be LMU basketball when we come back. UC Irvine has a 5-point lead. We'll actually keep it here.
Boy, that's the third open 3-pointer missed by Nelson. Lucky break for the Lions. He's not going to miss too many more of those.
Absolutely.
Spares run across midcourt. That's 2-2, Rabbit.
UCI switching up, looks like they're in a 2-3 zone now.
Irvine traditionally a zone team. Six on the shot clock. 4 seconds now. Jacko down way far inside, gets his own rebound. The putback. A shot clock violation. He's saying it hit the rim. That's a turnover there. Fourth. Irvine's got a 5-point lead here at the break.
Where you see an egg, we see a cure for cancer. Where you see a squid, we see the future of medical technology. Where you see the small details, we see the big picture. Where you see water, we see a path to sustainability. When you see the world differently, UCI.
Meet the Moores.
We're the Moore family, and we're always looking for ways to enjoy more.
So we called Time Warner Cable and got even more
than we expected.
Call now to get more.
More speed, like 300 meg.
More TV shows and movies on demand.
More places to make more unlimited calls.
Call 1-855-359-8364. For $89.99 a month, you'll get 100 meg ultra-fast internet, hundreds of HD channels, and unlimited calling to international destinations.
We find more good things every day.
More ways to watch more shows.
On more Wi-Fi connected devices in our house.
Time Warner Cable made switching easy with a 1 hour arrival window. They even made sure all of our connections were up and running before they left.
Why settle for less when
you
can
get
more?
Call 1-855-359-8364. For a limited time, get a free trial of Showtime for 1 year and ask how you could get a $300 reward card. Call for more now.
This is the play the referees are looking at right now. You see Janko go up. This was late in the shot clock, trying to see if this hit the rim or not. It stuffed itself from that angle. That might have hit the bottom of the backboard.
I think it hit the rim, right underneath the rim, right there.
There it does.
Well, the official who called the shot clock violation was at half court, so from his angle, he probably thought it was the bottom of the backboard.
We get another look at this to see if it did, in fact, hit the rim. If it didn't, it looks like it did. Should be LMU ball still.
Can't review it.
Where's the red challenge flag when you need it? Sunday night.
Nothing they can do about it. Either way, UCI basketball, they're up by five as we welcome you inside the Bren Center. I'm Trent Schlone with Rob Abreu, Bill Bano, here on KDOC.
Press again for LMU. They just gave up a wide open three off it and a layup prior to that. But you got to give Coach Dunlap credit for sticking to the game plan.
It looks like the officials are looking at that replay still to try to get a clue of what it the call should be. Maybe the results inconclusive in their eyes. UCI will inbound. That's Nelson overthrows Dunning.
That's exactly what LMU was looking for, a turnover.
Got to give Coach credit. They gave up two baskets. They stayed with it, forced their second turnover out of the press.
Second out of the press, third for the game for Irvine. 2-2 cross midcourt. UC Irvine all over the mid-major rankings. NBC Sports has been number 7 among mid-major teams. Campus Insiders.
Zone's giving LMU problems with the length of UCI.
Taken away by Galloway. College Insiders has been 18. Their preseason top 25 poll. Nelson. And a foul called away from the ball. Dimitopoulos hit. And that goes against Jacko.
Poor foul there by Jacko. Shot clock winding down. You see here him getting tied up with Giannis. And just a bad break for the Lions.
Fronting the post, he did a good job. He got him off. He didn't need to stay with that much contact.
Beautiful inbound play.
First against Jacko, fourth for the team. Three ball on the quarter, good. Jaron Martin knocks it down.
Great play by Dunning to kick that out to the open teammate.
There's that three, Rob, you talked about. They're not going to miss too many more open ones.
They were overdue.
Jump ball, this time LMU will keep It's 15-7, UCI up, 10:29 remaining in the first half.
LMU's got a little bit of a dilemma. When NJ's in, UCI's playing man, they can't get to the rim. They bring NJ out, they go zone, they still can't get to the rim.
Yeah, they're struggling with the zone. They're using a lot of clock, and they've, you know, turned it over and not looking good.
Guys, UCI has to be one of the toughest teams in the country to game plan against because their styles are so different, and that's a 5-second violation. Aitner's going to give it back, and now a timeout on the floor. A 30-second timeout called by LMU. Their styles are so different from when Mamadou's in the game versus when he's not in the game. It's like two different teams.
It's a nice luxury to have 2 7-footers, too. You take one out, you bring another one in, and you can play the same way. You know, as opposed to bringing a 6'6 guy in, which maybe you have to change your offensive and defensive philosophy a little bit with the second team, and they don't have to do that.
UC Irvine has a really big game coming up when they go to Central Florida. Boy, that's going to be fun. A matchup of 2 7-6 guys and freshman Taco Fall. Literally the biggest matchup ever. When was the last time you saw 2 7-6 guys on the floor at the same time?
From the same city, yeah. Dakar, Senegal.
That meeting will be in Orlando on Wednesday, LMU. UCI rather will leave early tomorrow morning to head east. At the shot clock. Shots missed. Comes Dunning now. Jaron Martin for three, his second. Martin with 2 threes in a row to make this a double-digit lead for UCI.
Martin hit that basically from the exact same spot where Nelson missed his.
And those threes you talked about earlier that they missed, most of them were in transition. There's another transition three where they didn't get matched up. You got to get back and find your shooters.
Well, they were getting good shots regardless. So none of those were bad shots, and you knew at some point they were going to start falling.
Martin, a better than 48% three-point shooter a year ago, and you saw him hit two right there and was left all alone. He's going to knock those down every time.
I think it's what makes UCI good. When, you know, they shot 39%, you know, from three as a team last year. That has to be a focus. You've got to take the three ball away, but it's easier said than done.
LMU calls another timeout. They only have one timeout remaining for the game. That's it. Mike Dunlap, a lot to talk about so far with this team. You see the timeouts reduced this year in college basketball. We've seen the shot clock shorten from 35 to 30. So if it seems like there's a lot more plays late in the shot clock, well, that's because it is. There's five fewer seconds. Poked away.
That's Martin again.
Third time, not the charm. And now Brandon Brown leading the pace for LMU. Lions need a bucket. Autumn Jacko. Long pass over to Spears. 14 on the shot clock. Got in traffic as Humphreys. Puts up a tough shot, no. Dunning fought to keep it alive. Last touched by the Lions, Antioch basketball.
That zone is forcing LMU to move the ball on the perimeter. They're not really attacking it, getting in gaps, going inside, and it's causing them problems. They got to figure that out soon.
Nelson inbound here, finds Martin. Past the midway point in the first half.
Beautiful pass.
Team accomplished all down underneath, gets the reverse.
Tell you what, UCI is just shredding that press defense of LMU.
The Greek god of Irvine, Giannis Dimakopoulos.
He's been impressive.
Off balance shot by Brown, draws the foul, gets it to go, and now he'll try to make this a three-point play.
And if LMU is going to get back into it, it's going to come from Jacko and Brown, and they really got to get Brown going. That was important that shot got from him.
And that's the Brandon Brown I expected to see more of. Hopefully that gets him going. He just, you know, used the ball screen, got in the lane, used his body, got an and one. You know, attacking, aggressive basketball. You know, turn him loose and take what the defense gives you.
at the second against Martin.
And that's one of the ways to shred his own right there is what Brown did. He attacked the gap.
Yep, absolutely.
Araldis Prinkinus comes in for UCI. So Mike Dunlap there. He's had to go out and get some key transfers from JC's. Free throw missed, but the pressure from LMU gets the Lions the ball right back.
LMU still just content to pass the ball around the perimeter. They got to penetrate.
Humphreys in the corner. 12 on the shot clock. Brown off balance, tries to pass it. Holy cow! Slam dunk, Autumn Jacko in the alley-oop.
Boy, from our angle, at first it looked like Brown was throwing up an air ball, but it was a beautiful pass to Jacko, who threw it down.
I'd like to see that replay. I think it got blocked from behind into an alley-oop pass.
It looked like a shot at first. Let's see it again.
No, it was. I think it was. It looked like he got a piece of it, but he didn't.
He even fooled us. Well done. That's some pretty good continuity right there from a couple of guys that really aren't used to playing together. This is just their second game on the same squad. And an offensive foul against NJI, a moving pick. So that's first.
That's not NJI's fault, that's the guard. The guard's got to wait on the screen, set his man up. When the guard leaves early, it puts the big in a position, bad position to get an offensive foul.
First against Momadou, fourth against UC Irvine. LMU has five fouls. Young aggressive there, nearly gets a strip, ends up sitting on top of the scorer's table. It's 20-11. We'll take a timeout on the floor. 7:54 left in the first half. 8 years by nine. Home floor up by nine here in the first half with 7:54 remaining. I'm Trent Schlong with Rob Abreu and Bill Pano. Here on KDOC in Southern California. So the 8-Eaters looking in, trying to improve to 2-0 on the young season. Russell Turner, the head coach, led UCI in the NCAA tournament for the first time in school history a year ago, thanks in large part to their large man in Momadou NJI, 7'6". NJI so far tonight, just 3 points. But he makes an impact in so many ways.
Three big blocks.
Taken away by Young. So Prinkinus lays up and in.
It's the second time Young's got a piece of a ball. First time wasn't able to cause a turnover there, was able to do it.
Absolutely, he's got great hands.
Young been very active in the passing lanes. Jacko, the reverse, gets around Momadou and scores.
Jacko now leading all scorers with 8 points. Really the highlight for the Lions in this first half.
So Prinkinus in the corner. 15 on the shot clock as Young holds, trying to set up the offense. So Prinkinus left side. 5 seconds now and a late foul appears to be against LMU. And when you get late in the shot clock like that, away from the basketball to pick up a foul, that's not good.
No, and their game plan is obviously to front him and get into his knees. And I think it's been good, but you got to be careful not to get the bonus and give him easy free throws, like you said, Trent.
Second against Humphreys, LMU now with 6 fouls.
Look out for a seal here by NJI on the inbound play.
And look at Herman get down and get into his knees, which is how you got to play those big guys.
Tutu's helping down. That opened up the three.
So Prinkinus left alone and knocks it down.
You know, we talk about NJ maybe not scoring so many points, but they're making a difference. Just his size alone opened up that three for Prinkinus.
Absolutely, Rob. Great point. That's their fourth three of the half already.
Amazing how many ways Momadou affects this game. That's going to be offensive goaltending, maybe.
Called the foul first, maybe.
I think he got two hands to the back on Jocko.
On a push.
No shot. The foul was first. That goes against my best.
Good call. Ref was on top of that.
First against best. It was away from the shot. Down just underneath when he was holding Jack.
It's just a great job by Brown just to give it over Njai, really to give his other player, his other teammate Jacko an opportunity to get the board there.
And on the other end of your point, I'd let Mamadou get tough twos as opposed to collapsing and giving up these threes. I think you're in trouble if you give these guys open threes like that.
Long pass over the top to Haney. Shot by Brown rolls in.
Again, if he could attack the gap and get to that free throw line, that sweet spot, Brown will have a big game.
Yeah, great screen by Shamar Johnson to get him open.
Dunning lays it in.
Again, the defense didn't want to come off Njai and just opened up the floodgates for Dunning.
You're seeing a lot of respect for the big fella in Njai so far tonight.
There's that sweet spot again.
But
right
Brown says,
line.
I don't care how tall he is, I'm going over the top, doesn't matter.
And he did, he shot that right over him.
After a slow start, Brown's got six now in the game.
Well, to your point, Trent, those are the two guys, Jacko and Brown, that got to get it going to keep them in the game. So hopefully they can. I think either way, the future's bright for LMU. These kids can play. They've got some good new young talent in here.
So far, Brown and Jacko combined for 14 of LMU's 17 points.
So Young shoots the free throw on the foul. Irvine now shooting in the bonus.
And again, three of those fouls, Njai drew. You know, it's something else that doesn't show up in the stat sheet, but helps you win games.
That went in and out of a pass on the offensive glass. Jump ball favors the Anteaters, and they'll get to keep it. That brings Luke Nelson back into the game. So Pernicus does his job, gets a big ovation by this crowd here at the Bren Center.
Great minutes from a role player, great minutes. They can play basketball in Lithuania. I coach Jonas Valanciunas with the Raptors. They've got some great coaches over there, and they do a really good job.
A lot of international players here at UCI. Luke Nelson from England, Mamadou from Senegal. We've talked about him, Dimitropoulos. Sopranikis from Lithuania. Young on the fall away, long 2-0. They had a lot of time. That's not a great shot for Young. Nelson takes it away. And then Jacko.
That might be two on Jacko. LMU can't afford to have him get into foul trouble.
Jacko gets tripped up there, ends up picking up the foul. That is his second.
I'm really impressed with the UCI zone. It's given LMU fits. That's their seventh turnover of the half, and they really have yet to solve that riddle other than Brown getting in there for a couple of those mid-range jumpers. But those are tough shots. You live with those.
That sends Luke Nelson to the line. Nelson, preseason all Big West pick, and 10 points in their opener, averaged 10 and a half last season. Went through a little bit of a shooting slump during the season two. It was big for them in the Big West tournament. Averaged 15 points per game in those three tournament games, including 17 in the final against Hawaii to get the Anteaters to the dance.
Good news is that's his first point for UC Irvine, his second point. They've got this lead without him.
I tell you what I like about Nelson's game. He missed a couple open shots, but they were all good shots. Hasn't forced the issue.
Any another guy that LMU wants to get going. Great three-point shooter for them. There's Brown.
UCI got out of the zone, back to man-to-man.
Smith really keeping a close eye on Haney. Tutu gets all the way into the rack, misses the layup. Dimitropoulos grabs the rebound, but loses it. And it'll go back to UCI. They'll get some free throws there. And that looked like the foul was against Peter Herman.
And LMU's going to that high ball screen, and it's been effective right there. They got a wide open layup off it. They just didn't finish. So I think you're going to see more high ball screens from LMU. They've just got to convert.
That's the first against Herman. Ninth against LMU, so UCI will get two free throws every time out the rest of the way. Front end of the one-on-one missed by Demacopoulos.
And really not being able to convert has been the theme of the season for LMU as Brown drives and misses yet again.
Taken away underneath by Shamar Johnson. Count it and one. And that was all heart, hustle, and strength.
And another high ball screen in transition. In the NBA, we call that a drag screen. It's very hard to guard. It opened up penetration, which forced help. And Johnson got the offensive rebound because his man had to go help.
It's great hustle there by Johnson. Rip that ball away.
I like what Coach Dunlap's doing here with his offense.
Johnson gets the roll. So he converts on the three-point play. Best pulls up from the free throw line and scores.
Boy, Best shown really all around game. Beautiful crossover, pull up, and hits the jumper.
For a 6'9", 6'10 kid, that was impressive. Another high ball screen. They rescreen it.
6'10 with a mid-range jumper makes you a really good mid-major college basketball player. That shot missed.
A nice strong move by Herman, but again, LMU can't convert. Shot 35% in the opener, and already here tonight, under 30% from the field.
UC Irvine 15-1 last year when they held their opponents to under 40%. Best goes strong but misses it. It'll stay Anteater basketball. UC Irvine with a 12-point lead. Best with the pull-up. Gets it to go under 4 to play.
This is Black Friday.
Does anybody want to be part of this?
No.
Well, Chevy has a better way. With Black Friday deals all month long.
That's a great idea.
What if you could get up to 20% cash back when you bought it?
Bam. 20% back? Awesome.
It's Black Friday. Find your tag and get cash back for 20% of the MSRP on select 2015 vehicles in stock. Or get 0% financing for 72 months on 2015 Silverado Light Duty models.
Find new roads at your Southern California Chevy dealers.
We at Time Warner Cable need to apologize to you. We no longer offer an excuse to stay home all day just in case the cable company decides to show up.
We're making a bunch of changes at Time Warner Cable, including one-hour arrival windows. We'll also tell you how long our visit will take before your appointment starts, so now you're not stuck waiting on us.
And if you still need an excuse to stay home all day, we've compiled a whole list at twc.com/stay-at-home.
Cinnamon. Milk. Cinnamilk. Cinnamon Toast Crunch. Crave those crazy squares.
Cinnamilk.
Mike Dunlap trying to figure out how is LMU going to try to slow down this size for UC Irvine as we welcome you back to the Bren Trench Club. Rob Abreu, Bill Bano. Rob, I don't know what LMU can do right now because UC Irvine is just out physicaling LMU in a lot of ways, and their big guys can hit jumpers too.
Well, they always say you can't teach size, and I think LMU is kind of finding that out tonight. But there's some positives to draw from. Brandon Brown's getting into a little bit of rhythm. Jacko unfortunately got the two fouls. He's playing strong again tonight. But really, they got to hit shots. You can't shoot 30% from the field and try to win.
Irvine inbound. They find Nelson open for three, leaves it short.
Again, nope. Another good shot by Nelson, though.
Nelson having a tough time trying to find his stroke. I like that no call by the officials right there.
I agree. Let him play.
Young gets tripped up from behind. And they'll get two shots. They're in the double bonus.
Boy, UCI fans have seen that before. Of course, the controversial call in last year's tournament. Louisville trying to give an intentional foul to give on Young. No call. Cost the Anteaters the game.
Second against 2-2. For about 15 minutes, UCI was America's darling last year. In the tournament, had a real shot to beat. Louisville came down to the final possession, 57-55. ended up being the final in favor of the Cardinal in the round of 64. First tournament appearance in UCI basketball history.
That's my favorite part about the tournament, watching the underdogs and rooting for them.
There's Matt Hayes with the ball now for the Lions. 15 on the shot clock for Brown. It's around Young, gets hit, going up, and gets it to fall. Brandon Brown, acrobatic bucket, and he'll go to the line to try to make it a three-point play.
I think now we're starting to see why this guy was Junior College National Player of the Year, as he goes up against two defenders, throws a windmill layup, and goes in, basket and the foul. Unbelievable play by Brown.
Johnson started to come up to set another high ball screen, and he rejected that. They're getting a little bit of rhythm. I think that could be something good for him if they stay with it.
Brown now with 9. The last foul is against Galloway, and that's his first.
Brandon Brown showing some big-time ability. I'll tell you, those are tough shots, and he makes them. Makes it look easy.
That's the second time he's done that tonight. Best changes his shot and scores.
Tell you what, Best is some player.
Nice move, athletic move for the big guy.
That was not an easy shot. No. He had a double clutch, kissed it really nice off the glass.
With the spin.
Yeah.
Best now with 8 points. When UCI graduated Will Davis last year, their leading scorer, the question was, who is going to replace him as the four? Best has answered that tonight. Spears' three's off the mark, but an offensive rebound for Brown.
Brown is quick, boy. He's a jet.
Off the foot of Young. That call was missed. They'll let him play. To the basket, no. Rebound, Best. Johnson on the take. Best tries to go coast to coast and loses it.
There's the quickness of Brown. Just took it up another gear there.
Best heard you talking about him, Rob. He tried to do a little too much there. He wanted to show us his Kevin Durant game.
Brown trapped in the corner, picked up his dribble, kind of got stuck. Oh, Spears open, but he gets blocked. Good recovery by the Anteaters. Nelson now under 2 minutes. Stutter step lays it in.
LMU taking a lot of chances with this press, and they're getting burned. They're giving up layups.
Brown on the spin. Foul is on the ground. No shot. But that will send Brown to the free throw line for a 1-1. Not this last play by Nelson.
Nice little patient stutter step. Goes under the defender. Beautiful right-handed layup.
Brown reminds me of Aaron Brooks, the NBA. You know, tiny.
Former Oregon point guard.
Yeah, jitterbug, you know. Really puts pressure on the defense with his quickness and his ability to finish among the bigger guys. He finishes there as if he's, you know, the same size as they are. And lightning quick.
Brown gets the free throw.
We talked about maybe the difference NJI makes for some of the other UCI players. Brown doesn't have that on his roster, so he basically has to create everything almost on his own.
And he's doing it this stretch without Jacko.
Yep.
Brown now with 11. That leads LMU.
Keeping a minute.
Irvine by 12.
Coach Dunlap, a little softer pressure, not trapping as much, trying to keep him in front. I like it. I think it's smart.
Dunlap, an outstanding coach with NBA experience. Russell Turner has some NBA experience too as an assistant coach at Golden State Warriors. His Best now in double figures.
Coach, he's in the zone. He's in the zone.
He hears you pumping him up, Rob. He's trying to make you look good. That does look smooth, though. That jump shot looks pretty.
Yeah, we're past heat check. He's on fire.
Yeah. We've seen him dish it off, drive to the hoop, put it on the floor, mid-range three-pointers.
We're under a minute now. 11 on the shot clock. Brown finds Hayes.
Great hands
by Nelson. 3 seconds on the shot clock. Spears got to put it up. He does, but he misses. And a timeout called by UC Irvine, their first. You would have lost it at the half anyway. Can't take it with you, so you burn it here. And Irvine will get a chance to set up their offense with 40.6 ticks left here in the first half. Anteaters by 14.
So, interesting point here. With the new shot clock, in the NBA, we have the two-for-one scenario with the 24-second clock. It comes into play, meaning if they can get a shot off in 3 or 4 seconds. Now, probably not enough time here, but if there were 45 on the game clock, you have time to get a shot off and then still get another one coming back. So you shoot it a little bit quicker, but you have sets and plays designed to get you a good shot, and then you're still going to come back and get another one. So I don't think they have enough time to do it here, but let's see. It'll be interesting.
Potentially last play for your last possession for UCI this half, Coach. What do you draw up?
I'd go to best. He's got the hot hand, maybe a high pick and pop, maybe get him on a pin down.
I think I'm wearing you over. Yeah. I'm wearing on you.
Yes, I'm a believer.
Best to a year ago, averages 3.4 points per game. Had 8 in their opener against UC San Diego. Is in double figures already in just one half tonight. Sopranikis, who's hit a couple threes already, misses that one. Best, though, keeps it alive.
He's doing everything.
Big time play there, tip out.
And now the Anteaters will get the final shot. Shot clock turned off, 10 seconds left in the half. They're bringing Mamadou way high. Young gets around it. Best for three. It's an air ball. Well, he did almost everything in the first half. Okay, so now we know his range. Regardless, UC Irvine goes into the half up 39-25. An impressive display by the Anteaters so far. Able to really control the game pretty much throughout. That's going to take us to a break ourselves. We'll be back. Some stats, highlights, analysis, all kinds of fun here at the Bren Center on college basketball's opening weekend. Anteaters by 2 touchdowns.
Yeah, we believe in the infinitely curious. We believe in the courageous of thought, the ones willing to fail again and again until one day they don't. When you have the courage to see things differently, to see opportunity where others see impossibility, amazing things will happen. Because at UCI, we believe that our individual differences are what ultimately make a world of difference.
This fall, not all blockbusters are movies. Get 0% financing for 75 months on most 2015 Cherokee models at the Jeep Black Friday Blockbuster Sales Event. It's the must-see event of the year. California residents get 0% APR for 75 months, plus $1,500 total bonus cash on the 2015 Cherokee Latitude.
All right, Rockettes, a 5, 6. Go back. We weren't together on that. Here we go. 3, 4, 5. Whoa, stop. Let's go back.
And 1, 2.
Whoa, stop there. Back to the top. Again, 2. Here we go. I bet we can do it even better. And 5, 6, 7, and.
It took the Rockettes years to master the kick line, but only a few moves to master paying bills on Chase.com. Technology designed for you, so you can easily master the way you bank.
Check this out. We got invited to a party.
You're invited to have fun with KDOC TV.
Are you ready?
All right!
Yeah, this is amazing!
At KDOC TV, we believe that everyone needs to have fun. So kick back, relax, and have some fun with us.
That's nice.
KDOC TV, Los Angeles. Do fun.
It's halftime here at the Bren Center. UC Irvine leading Loyola Marymount 39-25. UCI celebrating 50 years as an athletic department, and they got a pretty cool exhibit in the library. Let's take a peek.
2015 marks UC Irvine's 50th anniversary, and to commemorate the occasion, UC Irvine Libraries unveiled its Ready, Set, Zot exhibit celebrating 50 years of success in athletics.
One of the unique things about UCI is we're kind of like, innovators and leaders, and it's a place that you're not going to be held back.
The exhibit displays athletics' dedication to excellence, commitment to success, and perseverance in the face of adversity that built today's Eater Nation.
If I was to step and say this whole 20 years that I've been around UCI since 1996, it's amazing the growth just on campus, and it's spiraled into athletics.
When I was a student athlete here, our athletic director was Linda Dempsey, and she was the first female athletic director in Division I. So that sent a strong message to all of us that, you know, this is a place where you can really get things done.
I love watching that growth. I love feeling like I'm part of the growth. There were certainly people that came way before me that kind of blazed the trail. I got to pick up somewhere in the middle and kind of continue to help that growth.
The exhibit will run in Langston Library through April 2016. And as UC Irvine celebrates its first 50 years, it's inspired to shape what happens in the next 50.
Where you see an egg, we see a cure for cancer. Where you see a squid, we see the future of medical technology. Where you see the small details, we see the big picture. At UCI, we celebrate those who see the world differently. The infinitely curious. The courageous of thought. Understand that our individual differences are what ultimately make a world of difference. Where you see a stem cell, we see someone walking for the first time. Where you see waste, we see the future of sustainable energy. Where you see an iceberg, we see information. Where you see water, a path to sustainability. UCI is committed to having an impact on the world around us, finding far-reaching solutions that start right here in Irvine, with people like this, in places like these. We dream big, we have fun, and we approach every day with curiosity and optimism. Where you see an impossibility, we see an opportunity. When you see the world differently, you see I.
Pretty cool happenings going on here at UCI. By the way, also the top beach school in the country. That's a fun fact. Rob, Bill, and I will break down the first half for you when we come back. UC Irvine leading Loyola Marymount 39-25 at the break. Welcome back to the campus of UC Irvine. The Anteaters up 39-25 over Loyola Marymount so far here at the half. I'm Trent Schlum. He's Rob Abreu, Bill Bano down the way there. And guys, so far we have seen UC Irvine really show why they are not just the class, maybe the Big West, but maybe one of the top mid-major programs here on the West Coast.
Without a doubt, they're the favorites to win the Big West Conference this year. You know, schedule some dates on the calendar, Oregon and Kansas in December. You know, but all comes down really to the Big West tournament. But they can beat Kansas and Oregon. There's a chance that they might get an at-large bid in the NCAA tournament.
Bill, what's your assessment of UCI so far?
Well, I think their togetherness and chemistry and the experience stands out. I'm really impressed at this level how many big guys they got that can play. You know, you talked about Best, but, you know, Demacopoulos can play. Galloway, you know, they got that kid. He looked like he can do some things, and Russell's excited about him. and obviously Mamadou. I do like LMU long term though. You know, they're, you know, they got two big time players. I like what coach is doing. You know, they've just, you know, got to take time to grow and develop together. To have all, you know, five new starters out there, it's going to take time, but I think they could be dangerous as the season gets on here.
A complete overhaul of the roster from a year ago. Let's look at some of the stats here in the first half. As we break it down, the field goal percentage, that jumps out to me, guys. Huge. UC Irvine really outshooting LMU right now.
Well, LMU only 32%, but between Jacko and Brown, they're 8-for-14. The rest of the team, 2-of-15. So the Lions need somebody else to step up.
Right. Who that is going to be that next guy?
Scary thing for me for LMU is UC Irvine's only 4-for-12 from the three, but 11 of those 12 looks were wide open. They've got to shut that down. They got to get out and pressure those shooters, because it could be 7-for-12 this half if they don't address that.
UC Irvine's getting to the free throw line, but that's been the one area where they haven't been all that efficient.
Yeah, only 5-of-9. It's not really a concern for UCI long term, but that's obviously something you want to see some more improvement on.
And then the rebounding, we've mentioned UC Irvine's size. They have the edge there. LMU was dominant on the glass against Cal State Fullerton. That's one place where maybe they can pick it up here in the second half. You get a chance to look at some of those highlights in the first half, and what really was the Mike Best show early on. He gets going with this jumper here. A big first half for Best.
I did it all. 10 points, 5 rebounds. There you see the beautiful left-handed baby hook.
If LMU is going to get back in this game, here's the combo they need to get going. It's Brandon Brown to Autumn Jocko.
Yeah, we just saw there Brown to Jocko on the alley-oop. Both these guys, they're Brown again, that amazing layup. He found his sweet spot there at the free throw line in the middle of the first half. They combined for 19 of LMU's 25 first half points.
We saw Jaron Martin knock down that big three. He hit two of them in the first half, and more Best.
Yeah, Best was all over the place. But going back to Martin, Martin's got a quiet 6 points, 2-of-3 from beyond the arc. So far this season, 4-of-7.
UC Irvine has a 14-point lead here at the half. Second half coming up when we return on KDOC.
This is the car. Here's how I need it. Blu-ray metallic.
Yes, siritos.
6-speed automatic dual exhaust.
Yes, siritos.
20-inch aluminum wheels.
Yes, siritos.
Rally stripes.
Yes, siritos.
Plus touchscreen nav and roof rack.
On a convertible?
Just messing with you.
At Cerritos Auto Square's 2-week Black Friday sale going on now, get incredible deals on the world's largest selection of cars. But hurry, deals this good come just once a year at our 2-week Black Friday sale.
Yes, Cerritos Auto Square.
54? 54?
Right here, dude.
Here's your Call of Duty Ultimate Care Package.
Nice package.
Thanks. Oh.
55?
The Ultimate Care Package. A Tex-Mex Bacon Thick Burger and chance to win Call of Duty Black Ops 3 prizes like an epic in-game weapon camo at Carl's Jr.
George's girlfriend looks like Jerry.
Just because they look alike, that doesn't mean you're secretly in love with Jerry.
Elaine gives up on her dream.
What did you want to be?
I don't remember, but it certainly wasn't this.
On the next...
I'm not gay.
Neither am I.
Seinfeld.
Tonight at 11 on KDOC-TV, Los Angeles. Do fun. Ally Sheedy, Steve Guttenberg, and...
Beautiful Stephanie.
Number 5, Short Circuit. Tonight at 8 on KDOC-TV's Weekend Theater.
This fall, not all blockbusters are movies. Get 0% financing for 75 months on most 2015 Cherokee models at the Jeep Black Friday Blockbuster Sales Event. It's the must-see event of the year. California residents get 0% APR for 75 months, plus $1,500 total bonus cash on the 2015 Cherokee Latitude.
This UCI basketball game on KDOC-TV Los Angeles is brought to you by Time Warner Cable. Enjoy better. And your Southern California Chevy dealers and the Black Friday sale going on now all month long at your Southern California Chevy dealers. And Tough Shed, we're more than great sheds.
Anteaters up by 14 on the Lions from LMU here as we get ready to start the second half. Trent Schlob, Robert Grayu, Bill Pano. Bill, I want to ask you, because you're the coach, what kind of adjustments can LMU make to try to come back here in the second half?
Well, I think the biggest thing is, you know, they started the game with the deer in the headlights and kind of got off to a bad start. They got a little bit of rhythm there. So I'm anxious to see now that that's behind them, you know, and behind them in the first half, if they come out and play a little bit more relaxed and with a little bit more confidence. Adjustment-wise, I thought their best offense was the high ball screen. So getting back to that a little bit more. And then they have to decide, you know, the give and take with the full court press. You know, maybe they soften it up a little bit, get them to use a little bit of time. They were aggressive with it, and they gave up a bunch of threes and a bunch of layups. So coach has to make that determination.
One thing we've seen so far tonight, when LMU's been able to play their style and get into their kind of rhythm, their kind of flow, they've been good. They're going to have a really tough time if they're stuck playing UC Irvine's game.
No, without a doubt, they're not going to be able to match up man for man against UCI. Just a more experienced, bigger team. So they're going to have to find extra ways to get back into this ball game.
They will rely on Brown, who passes over to Hayes. Brown guarded by Alex Young as we are back for the start of the second half. UCI up by 14 here at the Bren Center in Irvine, California. These two teams 11-11 against each other all time. Irvine had the last meeting in LA last season. Good defense by Dunning, get his hands there, but he had his hand on the back and he's gonna get called for the foul.
LMU got bailed out there, trapped in the corner with the shot clock winding down. Just fortunate Dunning reached across and got that foul.
And no need to foul. NJI was waiting at the rim. That was getting blocked.
First against Dunning. And then Dunning picks up his second just like that on the shot. Stephen Haney had a real quiet first half and now gets the free throw line here.
Haney hit the first bucket of the game. It's been quiet ever since. If the Lions are going to get back into it, they need role players like Haney to step up in the second half.
Haney, a transfer from Central Florida. Huge threat in transition. This is a guy that took 10 threes against Cal State Fullerton in their opener on Friday. Makes the first free throw.
Like they said, two great screens to free him up. I think the LMU bigs have got to really focus and set better screens to get these guards open.
Haney, a good shooter, knocks down both free throws. Got the deficit to a dozen. That's Young with it. That's Best. Goes high, low to Mamadou.
Beautiful play by Best. Just threw it softly enough for NJI. Beautiful touch on the pass, and then Mamadou threw it down.
And that's the difference. When Best didn't get going, all of a sudden now LMU has to respect Best's ability to shoot. Pretty much that respect led to the bucket.
And he hit that shot, that corner elbow free throw line shot in the first half.
Brown around the edge. Two on the shot clock. They're going to get rid of it. That's Hayes for three. No. Like LMU forgot about the new rule, the shorter shot clock for this year. Ran out of time. Mamadou the Best this time, who gets hit. Puts up the shot. No good. We'll get a couple of free throws here, though.
They double-teamed him that time, and that led to Mamadou finding Best under there. Good pass for the big fella.
Second against Peter Herman. First against LMU here in the second half.
He looked like a Senegalese Bill Walton on that play with the one-hand sling pass.
That might be the first time Senegalese Bill Walton has ever been said. Best hits the first free throw. He now has 11. Irvine's up by 15. It's their biggest lead of the night.
See Coach Dunlap wastes no time getting Jacko back in the second half.
Autumn Jacko was their spark when he came in the first half. We'll see if he can do it again here. Brown gets hit by Young, drew the contact, and will get rewarded with some free throws.
Another high ball screen. Good screen, got him open, and forced the defender to trail and ended up bumping into him. Good, smart play by Brandon Brown there to draw that contact.
That's the first against Young, but the third foul against UC Irvine here in the first minute 46 of the second half. Brown makes the first down with 12 points.
I love Brown. Brown can play. Brown's going to make money playing basketball somewhere.
Second free throw, no good. Autumn Jacko.
Didn't want to get his third there. He backed off. Smart play by Jacko.
Right. Dunning secures it.
Another strong show.
Leaves Best open for the long two. Can't convert. Mamadou unable to secure the offensive board.
It's one of the better defensive possessions the Lions have had. Had a strong show by Jacko and great rotation.
Nice pass. Wow.
And Shamar Johnson able to score. Another transfer.
Turnover.
Big time left-handed scoop pass along the baseline by Brandon Brown. That's impressive.
One thing is, how long can Brandon Brown carry this whole team on his back? Someone else is going to have to step up for the Lions.
I agree. I think they need to make some threes. They got to open up the perimeter with some made threes. Here's one.
So it'll be UC Irvine basketball. Second against Johnson.
Looks like Johnson and Dunning got tied up down below. Let's take a look at the replay. Just caught him with the hip, illegal screen. Turnover again by the Anteaters.
Jacko with the interception. Into the corner now. LMU is going to have to bring it back out.
LMU's got to capitalize on those turnovers.
And then they cough it up. Ends up in the hands of Dunning. One-on-one to the basket. Dunning lays it up and in.
Beautiful play by Dunning. You see that NBA-type step layup. He avoids the charge.
We call that a Euro step in the NBA. Big-time move.
Second bucket for Dunning. He's got four. Anteaters by 15. 11 on the shot clock. That's Brown with it. Jacko. There's Johnson underneath. No, gets his own rebound.
He's gonna get off.
It looks like a shot clock violation. Johnson got stuck down low. Good defense by the Anteaters.
Big Mamadou, another block. I think he had two in that possession and didn't leave his feet.
And how about the blocks that don't end up on the stat sheet where Johnson has to pump fake because Injai's presence is making him change his move.
Absolutely. Great point. They've been going to this side ball screen with Injai. They've scored twice on it. Let's see. There it is again.
High-low with Best again.
Best tries to find Mamadou. Another pick for Jacko. Then they try to get him on the alley. Broken up. Fast break opportunity for Nelson. And an offensive foul. He used the shoulder trying to create some space. He gets hit with the player control foul. But Dunning lays it in and Irvine's up by 15.
Local, we challenged our grill masters to create our tastiest bowls ever, like our fajita with peppers and onions, and our unwrapped whole wheat burrito with hand-sliced avocados and fresh pico. When grill masters are inspired, delicious things happen. New Grill Master Pollo Bowls at El Pollo Loco.
This is Black Friday.
Oh my God!
Does anybody want to be part of this? Well, Chevy has a better way. With Black Friday deals all month long.
That's a great idea.
What if you could get up to 20% cash back when you bought it?
Bam! 20% back? Awesome.
It's Black Friday. Find your tag and get cash back for 20% of the MSRP on select 2015 vehicles in stock. Or get 0% financing for 72 months on 2015 Silverado Light Duty models.
Find new roads at your Southern California Chevy dealers.
We at Time Warner Cable need to apologize to you. We no longer offer extended periods of free on-hold elevator music when you call us.
We're making a bunch of changes to Time Warner Cable, including reducing how long you could wait on hold. Now we'll even call you back at a time that's convenient for you.
But for those of you who'd miss our old on-hold music, please check out our greatest hits at twc.com/onholdhits.
Good news. El Pollo Loco's three-course family meal with fire-grilled chicken, sides, and churros now comes with handmade enchiladas. Better news. It's so much food, your leftovers will have leftovers. New $20 three-course family meal. El Pollo Loco. Crazy you can taste.
Here's the last play before the break, as you see where Nelson picks up the offensive foul. Brandon Brown, yeah, he sold it a little bit. That's okay. It results in an opportunity for LMU to try to get some points back.
Little acting job, but me and Coach were talking. That was another great opportunity for maybe Nelson to use the same move Dunning used, that little Euro right. step to avoid the charge. Because when you get to the next level, everyone's trying to draw a charge.
LMU will inbound. If shooting percentage tells the story, UCI shooting nearly 55%. As for LMU, just 31. Anteaters by 15. Humphreys with it.
I'd like to see that 31 number without Jacko and Brown. It's probably below 20.
Brown fires that one well short. Put back no good by Humphreys. LMU will get another opportunity. Bast with the hedge. Brown looked at Mamadou and said, nope, I'll go pass over to Johnson, who misses the shot. Rebound Mamadou.
Njai's fifth block tonight.
Five swats for the big fella.
Njai once blocked 11 against Cal State Long Beach last season.
And I talked to you, Trent, coming out of that timeout. It's the first time I saw Brandon Brown show a little fatigue and breathing heavy, and he was short on that last shot. You know, he's had to do so much. You know, it seems like he's getting a little fatigue. Let's see if he can play through it.
It's hard to take him off the floor. He's been everything for LMU.
There's also the belief, Coach, and you probably know more than I do, that players don't get tired during games. Is that a myth? Is it true?
That's a myth. You know, and I think Coach might have to just give him a minute here, maybe before the next TV timeout, so he gets a little bit of extra rest. But to your point, Trent, you take him out, you may go on a 6-0 run. So
Martin throws it away, 11th turnover for the Anteaters. They're still up 15 here. LMU not going away. Still with plenty of time, just under 15 minutes remaining here in the contest on the opening weekend of college basketball. Some good mid-majors here in Irvine, California, LMU, UCI. Thanks for joining us here on KDOC. Trent Schwarm, Robert Gray, Bill Bano. That's Humphreys' three. The back of the rim, no. Great hustle there by McClendon, and a foul against Irvine. LMU will keep it.
I really believe if LMU is going to get back in this game, they got to make some threes. I thought that one went down, that would have been big, but they're not going to win this game, I don't think. You know, making two, somebody's got to help Brandon Brown out and make a couple threes.
And again, like you pointed, Humphreys got that shot due to the penetration by Brown. He's got to do him a favor and knock that down.
That last foul was the third against Young. That sends him to the pine. Nelson back in. Another missed shot by LMU.
Look out. That could be big. It's on Jacko.
Another wide open three. Again, Brown got him the shot, too, off penetration.
Jacko now with three.
You leave him in, Coach? At this point, you almost have to.
Yeah, you know, I would. I think let's see where it goes here in the next minute or two.
Best to the hoop. Count it.
Boy, Best is just going to make a killing this season at that high post with all the respect that Njai is demanding.
Yeah, that's the first thing Russell Turner said to me when I spoke to him Saturday, that Mamadou does so many things. He draws so much attention. He makes the game easier for other players, and we've absolutely seen that tonight, especially with Best.
14 for Best, who on paper appears to be pretty much the fifth option on this in this UCI starting five. He's had a great night tonight. Now with 15 points, UC Irvine has their biggest lead at 18. 48-30. Brown can't get the floater to fall. Rebound Best. Comes Martin, 3-on-2. Martin, all the way to the rack. No, but Best! points for Mike Best.
And the Anteater zone just giving LMU all kinds of trouble.
And this ties a career high for Best. He had 17 against Hope International back in 2011. And how about this highlight right here for the big man?
See Martin driving down, beautiful layup attempt. Comes up short, here comes Best following and puts it down with two hands right in Humphrey's face.
And a standing O for Best as he goes to the bench. UCI up by 20.
And Coach Dunlap decided to give Brandon Brown a break, which I think is important.
Another 3-on-2 leaves Nelson open to lay it in. Anteaters pulling away here, up by 22, 13:04 to play.
The floodgates have opened.
And Mike Dunlap will call his final timeout. UC Irvine in control, up by 22. Big thanks to Best, who's got 17.
Never before has performance sounded so revolutionary. Watch the big finish of The Hunger Games, Mockingjay Part 2, November 20th. Get revved up with 0% APR for 75 months on select 2015 Dodge Chargers at the Black Friday Blockbuster Sales Event on Now. California residents now get 0% APR for 75 months plus 2,000 total bonus cash on the 2015 Dodge Charger RT.
Are you ready for changing weather? Make your life easier with the ultimate winterizing accessory, a tough shed storage building or garage. Not all sheds are created equal. Protect your belongings with the only buildings durable and secure enough to earn the Tough Shed name. For smashing year-end deals on the best storage buildings and garages, there's only one place to look, Tough Shed. 7 factory direct locations to serve you. Call 1-800-BUY-TOUGH for the store nearest you and visit us online at toughshed.com.
Ready to winter with Infiniti. Now through January 4th, lease the new Infiniti QX50 for $329 a month. Visit your Southern California Infiniti retailer.
Travis Best has been the best so far tonight. 17 points, ties a career high for the starting four of UCI. You look at his numbers from a year ago, and it's been a different story this evening. UC Irvine up by 22 here as we get closer to the midway point in the second half. Rob Abreu, Bill Bano, I'm Trent Schloan. As UC Irvine now in complete control. LMU to inbound it. Dunlap and the Lions out of timeouts.
Zone's really forcing them to use a lot of clock, which is going to shorten the game and make it even harder to come back.
Well, when they had Brown in the game, he was the only one to penetrate the zone. Now that he's not in there, they're really struggling to get any kind of offensive game going.
Jacko leaves it short, but gets his own rebound.
No one can penetrate that gap. They're just content swinging it around the perimeter.
And in the zone, if you just get in the gap and make two guys play one, you're 4-on-3. Somebody else is going to get open. It's a simple concept, but you got to attack the gaps and make two guys commit.
And now we're seeing some lack of focus mistakes like that last turnover right there for LMU. Here comes Jaron Martin. There's Smith, freshman from Godinez High School in Santa Ana, turns it over.
LMU changed their pick and roll coverage on that play.
Humphreys for a three, no.
Three wide open threes for him.
LMU hasn't scored in over 5 minutes. UC Irvine's up by 22, and that pretty much sums it up for the Lions, 52-30. LMU hasn't scored in nearly 6 minutes. They're trying to figure out how to put one in against this tough UCI defense, 52-30. Anteaters up. Here are some games coming up for the Lions. They'll go to Colorado State next, and they'll come back home for Antelope Valley, CSUN in the Big West. Go to the Pac-12 against Oregon State. Start of December. Good schedule here on the West Coast. Couple of pretty good mid-major programs here. LMU last in the West Coast Conference a year ago. UCI first in the Big West. Jacko. It's around Smith, way off. Now the rebound goes to Humphreys. 8 on the shot clock. Hayes for 3, knocks it down, just their second of the night from deep.
Hopefully that gets them going. I think that's they're going to have that from multiple guys to get back in this game.
And Hayes played well in the opener. He had 14 minutes off the bench, 6 points against Cal State Fullerton.
But that just his first bucket tonight. There's a turnover.
Good D by Jocko.
LMU not going away. Spears for 3. Can't hit it. And it'll be UC Irvine basketball, and that's a big miss.
Wide open. They've missed probably 7 or 8 wide open threes.
2 for 11 overall.
You could feel the momentum starting to swing the way of LMU. You hit that 3. Now you feel like you're right back in it.
Another turnover.
Irvine struggling handling the basketball in the last couple minutes here. 3 in the corners, no good. Rebound, Dimitropoulos. Now here comes Nelson.
There's a lid on that basket for LMU.
Martin for 3. No good. Rebound, Smith. Galloway, they get tangled up. Galloway ends up with it.
I think Martin was too open on that 3.
Nelson's 3. No good, foul on the ground. Appeared to be against Dimitropoulos. Pushed off, trying to get that rebound. Ends up being UCI, or LMU basketball rather. Second against Dimitropoulos, 6th against the Anteaters.
Story of the game for LMU, can't make shots. Getting some wide open looks.
Now Mamadou comes back into the contest, as does Mike Best. Hear the roar of the crowd, fired up for Best. What a night he has had, 17, matches a career high. UC Irvine, 8 turnovers. So far here in the second half, 14 for the game. Still 10 minutes left. Humphreys doesn't shoot, instead it's Hayes. Leaves it way short. LMU's misses. They haven't even been that close. Smith to the basket. Looked like he double dribbled. He did. Ball right back to LMU. 9 second half turnovers here in just over 10 minutes for UCI.
Brown coming back.
He's gotten a bit of a break here. But a couple of timeouts to recover. They'll count on him for the final 9 minutes of change. It's Hayes for 3. This time he gets it.
He really stepped into that confidently, in rhythm. Hayes now with 2 3-pointers tonight. He's the only guy to be able to hit a shot.
Some of these other guys got to step up without a doubt.
Young gets the pick from Mamadou. So that's the 4th against Jacko. 6th against LMU. Jacko will stay in the game playing with 4 fouls here.
I like it. I don't think coach has a choice. I agree. I'd roll with him.
Fortunately for Coach Dunlap, it seems like the foul trouble really slowed his rhythm. Came out strong in the first half with 8 points. Dunlap been quiet looked, ever since.
Dunlap looked like he was going to stick with Jacko, and Stens brings in Mornar late. They turn it over on the inbound. Mamadou makes Herman feel that one. He misses the shot. He'll get free throws.
It's great anticipation by Herman getting out in the lane, causing that steal. See Herman up trying to get that shot off over Injai. Injai slaps him across the wrist. Herman's going to go to the line for two.
Smart foul. I like it. No layups. Make him earn it from the free throw line.
Especially with a team that struggles putting the ball in the hole.
Coach, I want to ask you in your opinion of Mamadou Injai right now. From the last time you saw him when you coached him at the Adidas Nationals to the way he looks right now, it appears to me in watching the last couple of years, he continues to improve his athleticism. Are you seeing the same thing I am?
Yep, I do. I still think he has a long way to go. But Coach, the biggest thing is will he get with the strength coach? Will he work on it? Coach says he is, and I have seen some improvement. But also he's got a ways to go. He's got to keep working.
Sure. UC Irvine up 52-36. Mamadou Injai, 5 points tonight. He's had a number of contributions that you don't see in the box score. Free throw missed by Herman. LMU's got to capitalize on opportunities if they want to try to come back into this one.
That already makes Njai's foul worth it.
Right. Second free throw, good.
All right, LMU's on a run here. They got it down to 15. Let's see if they can build some momentum with some stops.
Irvine was once up by 22. Lions on a 7-0 run, and there's another offensive foul against Nelson.
I think Brown needs a SAG card. His acting is just...
That's big time, though. That's an art form. That's two of those he's gotten.
It's a skill. I agree.
See a frustrated Russell Turner on the bench there.
Shows basketball intelligence when you can pull that off.
Go up top to Hayes. Short corner shot, no good.
Boy, they had good ball movement there too. Just cannot put it in the basket.
Njai affected that. He forced that miss for sure.
Nelson's three in and out. Mamadou with a rebound and slam. And now Mamadou's going to try to make it three.
Trent, he sent that down with authority. Trying to send a message as he flushes it down. See here, seals Herman off. Herman had no chance. Slam dunk and the foul for Mamadou Injai.
It helps when you don't have to jump.
Yes, it does.
Big time seal, though. Herman was fronting him, and he sealed him and kept him from the basket and got that ball.
Free throw, no good. Rebound by Dunning. That Mamadou slam stopped a 7-0 run by LMU. They try to go back into the big fella. Foul away from the ball. Let's see that slam again, guys.
Huge play, because if they get that rebound, they're on a 7-0 run. They go down, hit another three, It's a different game. It's a game of inches, boy.
And, Coach, Njai did a great job stealing there, but with LMU, you have no choice but to front the post. When you front the post, you give up that position, and that's the end result.
Yeah, it's what Russell talked about, Coach Turner said. He does so many things that don't show up in the stat sheet and draws so much attention.
Nelson hits the first free throw. He's got 7 tonight. Nelson's had a quiet game by his standards. UC Irvine up big, 55-37. They were once up 22. Second free throw by Nelson, good. The junior from England. There's an offensive foul on the screen, illegal pick sent by Shamar Johnson.
And again, it's the guards. That's not Shamar's fault. That's the guard leaving too early, not waiting, and causing that offensive foul. And that's a huge thing in the NBA.
Third against Johnson.
Front of the post again.
Which opens up a drive.
And there's Best now with 19. A career night for Best.
Give Mamadou that assist.
Nelson with the strip and the finger roll.
Nelson did a great job. Got ahead out in front of his defender, sealed him off, and was able to get the easy layup.
So how does UCI respond to LMU's 7-0 run? They're on an 8-0 run. And now have their biggest lead of the night, 23. Five on the shot clock. Found in some traffic. Hayes gets rid of it right before the shot clock nearly draws iron. Barely, rather. Now here comes Young. Pulls up for three early in the shot clock. Missed. Brown on the other side. Tough shot. No. Rebound Momadou. Inside of 7 minutes. Five rebounds. Nelson gets hit. It's going to go against Johnson. UC Irvine rocking. Now Nelson getting the strip and score. They're up 23.
This is Black Friday.
Does anybody want to be part of this?
No.
Well, Chevy has a better way. With Black Friday deals all month long.
That's a great idea.
What if you could get up to 20% cash back when you bought it?
Bam.
20% back? Awesome.
It's Black Friday. Find your tag and get cash back for 20% of the MSRP on select 2015 vehicles in stock. Or get 0% financing for 72 months on 2015 Silverado light duty models.
Find new roads at your Southern California Chevy dealers.
Meet the Moores. We're the Moore family, and we're always looking for ways to enjoy more.
So we called Time Warner Cable and got even more
than we expected.
Call now to get more.
More speed, like 300 meg.
More TV shows and movies on demand.
More places to make more unlimited calls.
Call 1-855-359-8364. For $89.99 a month, you'll get 100 meg ultra-fast internet, hundreds of HD channels, and unlimited calling to international destinations.
We find more good things every day.
More ways to watch more shows.
On more Wi-Fi connected devices in our house.
Time Warner Cable made switching easy with a 1 hour arrival window. They even made sure all of our connections were up and running before they left.
Why settle for less when
you
can
get
more?
Call 1-855-359-8364. For a limited time, get a free trial of Showtime for 1 year and ask how you could get a $300 reward card. Call for more now.
Have yourself a night, Mike Best. 19 points, a career high, and you see how important he has been. Best has been the best of the best tonight for both teams. You can just see how important he has been for UC Irvine this evening. Beyond just an X factor, he's been the difference.
Showed a lot of skill. Like that last move, he moved the ball around away from the defense, hung in the air, and finished. So those are some big-time plays. This kid's got a chance.
8 of 12 from the field, 19 and 7 for Mike Best tonight. UC Irvine has dominated in the paint, outscoring LMU 32 to 12 in the painted area. Free throw by Nelson, good. 61-37, UC Irvine leading. Nelson in double figures with 11.
Tell you what, Mike Best is 8 of 12, and LMU overall 13 of 53 from the floor.
Wow. It has been a tough shooting night, and that's an understatement for LMU. Boy, Tosh misses that one.
Wide open.
One thing we've seen tonight, Jacko's been a little handcuffed. Against Cal State Fullerton, he was really able to control that game as Young gets the putback to fall.
How about Young amongst the trees, able to get that tip in?
But Jacko's really been in foul trouble most of the night, hasn't really been able to get much of a rhythm.
After that initial start, Irvine's done a good job adjusting and taking the basket away from him, staying in front, using their length.
Eaters by 27, under 6 minutes. Irvine's on a 12-0 run. Brandon Brown trying to end the run and does. He hits the long two.
Tough shot, big time shot.
That's what they say about great players. Great players hit shots that start runs, and they hit shots that stop runs.
14 for Brown, and Dunning slams it home.
Give that basket to Njai. They were afraid to leave him.
Dunning thought about it, looked at the big fella and said, no thanks, I'll take this one myself. Hayes for three, yes!
Hayes now 3 of 6 from behind the arc. The rest of the Lions 1 for 10.
Yikes. Best again, hit from behind. You can't stop Mike Best right now. This is incredible.
Ran the floor, I tell you, he's doing it all different types of ways. Mid-range, running the floor, finishing in transition.
And it just hasn't been the offense. He's got 8 rebounds, two more, he'll have a double-double.
Guys, if you would have told me that Mike Best was going to have 20-plus tonight, I would have thought you were crazy.
And one of the underrated things about that play there was the catch. You know, a lot of these big guys, one of the weaknesses we always see is hands, and UCI has big guys, but they all can catch the ball.
Irvine graduated a great player, Will Davis. He was their leading scorer. He played the four for UCI last year. Doesn't appear that the Anteaters will be skipping a beat with Best playing like this. He's got 22 now for UCI.
He reminds me of a player for the Hawks from Bucknell, Mike Muscala, who was on nobody's radar and just got better and better, was in the D League. Very similar game.
Best comes out, gets a standing ovation from the crowd. And Dunning gets hit with the foul there.
I don't know how that's a foul on Dunning, but.
I agree, tough call there. I thought he blatantly elbowed him right in the jaw.
That's the third against Dunning, and now the official's gonna talk about this. Looked like he was the one that took it in the chin.
They may change this.
And this one may be coming back. Let's take a look. You see where Boy Touch.
Wasn't intentional, but it's part of the game, but I don't see how that's a foul on Dunning.
No Dunning, there was no contact there. No foul. I think they'll change that.
A no call should have been the right call. I'm not so sure that was a foul on Touch either. It just kind of got stuck wrong place, wrong time. It certainly didn't appear to be or should have been a foul against Dunning.
It's contact sport, it's part of the game, it happens.
So the officials are talking about now our crew tonight, Michael Reed, Richard Kuhnko, Michael Greenstein.
Big Giannis Dimakopoulos is back in the game. He's been solid.
And that's basketball. Tough for Dunning that he took that one to the chin. But no way that should be a foul against the senior for UCI. If it stands, it would be his third. He picked up 2 quick ones to start the second half.
He might need to get his SAG card. I'm not sure he got hit. It looked like he got hit. He sold it, but I'm not sure there was contact with the elbow, even though he did swing it.
That's what you get when you have 2 programs from Southern California playing. You get great acting.
Hollywood's not far away.
There you go. Hollywood on display tonight. UC Irvine rolling so far, up 69-42.
In case you're wondering at home, Dunning is not a drama major, sociology major.
Thank you for double-checking, Rob. I'm glad we know now.
Confirmed.
UCI 21-13 a year ago, went to the NCAA tournament for the first time in school history. It's been a long time since LMU has been to the dance. Coming off an 8-23 season, they won their opener against Cal State Fullerton, will likely fall to 1-1, though still just under 5 minutes left. LMU down, but not quite out just yet. Wait to see if UCI can finally close this one out.
I'm excited about this UCI team, following them all year.
With the 27-point lead. It appears that there was a foul on the play and then a flagrant one. So we're going to shoot free throws on both sides. Interesting, guys.
I hope that's not a flagrant on Touch.
Let's see one more time.
I mean, that's a common basketball
right,
move to catch
yeah.
and rip through. He's just trying to square up and pivot.
I know you got to be extra careful with the concussions that are so many people concerned about in all of sports. And Dunning appears to be all right. He's staying in the game. I don't know how hard he was hit. Billy, you think he wasn't hit at all.
Yeah.
But to call a flagrant there, I think, is a little excessive.
Yeah, you know, I agree, except he did swing it, and I think the referees have got to make sure things like that don't happen. And Rob, you're right, it was a basketball play, but you know, swinging that elbow like that, I think that's probably a point of emphasis with the referees. So
Dunning fouled Boyd Todd before that contact happened. So Todd is going to shoot free throws here, and then UC Irvine's going to get free throws on the other end because the flagrant one called against Boyd Todd. 4 minutes, 51 seconds left here in this contest. As LMU continues to discuss with the official what this is all about. Todd's first free throw, good. Todd, a junior transfer from Northeast Community College in Nebraska. All-conference JC player a year ago. Very athletic guy, pretty good shooter. Hits the two free throws, and now Dunning. You get free throws on the other side for UCI. First one is good. And he gets the second as well. So a couple of subs coming in. 2-2 for LMU. Does it for Brown. He heads to the bench at least for now. Get a quick breather. Just under 5 minutes remaining here in the contest. There's Alex Young. 4 minutes. 47 seconds left. 71-44. UCI leads. Alex Young misses that shot. Rebound LMU. Little inside out action for Spears. No good. Mornar with the rebound. Now Mornar's shot. Clanks off the front of the iron. Rebound Dinakopoulos. Dunning secures it. So we approach the 4 minute mark. 71-44. UCI leading LMU.
Looks like Coach Turner's going to use a little clock. Try to milk this a little bit, run a play at the end of the clock. Smart, I like it.
Inside of 4 minutes when Dunning was pushed out of bounds. Foul goes against Touch. We'll take a break. Final stretch when we return. Is that Peter the Anteater making an appearance? Looks like it. Pretty happy right now with UC Irvine up 71-44 here. Deep into the second half, 3:54 remaining here on KDOC. I'm Trent Schlum with Rob Abreu, Bill Bano. Bring you college basketball here in SoCal on KDOC. We thank you for joining us tonight. UC Irvine rocking on their home floor tonight. Picked to win the Big West against the team in LMU that was picked to finish last in the West Coast Conference. Dominic Dunning will go to the line. Shooting 1-1 here. 8 points for Dunning. I guess he got two. First one up and good, and now he can make this to get into double figures. Anteaters had 5 players in double figures first time around. Heading that way again tonight. Though Mike Best has been a bit of a hog with 22.
I think we might have seen the last of Brandon Brown, too. I'm not sure Coach will come back to him with this deficit, and they probably got a game coming up soon as well.
And they'll be at Colorado State middle of next week. There's Jacko off the front of the rim. Rebound Galloway. Now we get a chance to see some of the depth of UC Irvine, and that's been one of the things that in conference play in the Big West has separated UC Irvine from the pack.
I really like this team. I'm excited to watch them through the course of this year. I think they're going to be an upset special in the tournament, and They got a good thing going here. Coach has done a great job, both coaching and recruiting. They got some players.
They have some of the highest expectations the Big West team has had since about 5 years or so. Late in the shot clock, Martin's off balance. He misses. Long Beach State, we know, but I think back 2011, 2012, a lot of people like that team. UC Irvine might be the best Big West team since. Jacko misses. Traps in the corners. Touch. Jacko with the left hand. Nobody gets hit. So that's going to be free throws for Jacko, who had 22 and 10 in his first game. He has been much more quiet so far tonight. 8 points, 4 rebounds.
Has not scored in the second half.
Yeah. And that's been tough for LMU. They really count on him to be a producer on offense.
I still like the future of LMU. I think, you know, with Jacko and Brown and, you know, some of these other guys got to step up. But, again, you know, this is Coach Dunlap's first real recruiting class. You know, it takes time. But they're his kids, and I think they're going to continue to learn and grow. I like what he's doing. He can really coach. And they just got to continue to get better. They ran into a really tough team in UCI tonight. They were just overmatched.
You see Dunlap go out and get a number of really good transfers, kind of sending that message, hey, we don't want to rebuild. We want to win now. Though it takes time, Coach.
Yep.
Smith caught in a little bit of trouble there, but gets hit. He's going to get some free throws. That's against Muniz, 2-2. Third against 2-2. Now here comes Brandon Smith, freshman. Went to Godinez High School, modern day, a powerhouse here in Southern California, wanted him. He said, no, I want to play Godinez. He's the best player ever to come out of that school. UC Irvine, this staff very high on what he can do.
Take him down.
This is the free throw.
You figure anywhere else in the Big West, he'd probably be starting, but UCI is so loaded, he's coming off the bench.
I just look at the players that UCI could be redshirting this year, would start on some teams in the Big West.
And that's a sign of what Russell's doing with this program, to have that, the type of veteran talent, but also young guys in the pipeline waiting to come up when the seniors graduate next year.
Galloway was one of those guys last year. They had Will Davis, who was a senior. Galloway came in as a freshman, really could have played, would have started on some teams in the conference. They decided to redshirt him, let Will Davis finish out, and let Galloway step right in.
And have two players like he and Smith waiting in the wings. Yeah. You know, they're going to develop. They're going to do it at their own pace and then be able to step in next year and really pick it up.
Jacko gets the roll with the line. He's in double figures with 10. Sean Ray into the game for the first time tonight for UC Irvine. Number 20, senior. This has been an impressive showing by the Anteaters. The same LMU team beat Big West foe Cal State Fullerton on Friday night.
Talking to Russell on Saturday too, not only did they play Louisville close, but they played 6 or 7 high major teams, and they lost them all, but he said they were right there with all of them. They got another tough schedule this year. I think they're playing 6 or 7 more, and he thinks hopefully this is the year they can get over the hump. You only got to win 2. If you can win 2 of those, you're going to get some serious at-large consideration.
And that's what I was thinking halftime. You know, I mentioned Oregon, Kansas. You know, if they win those two games or beat Oregon and just show well against Kansas, this looks like a top 25 team. They might get an at-large bid.
I agree.
They're going to be playing in the Wooden Legacy that's at Honda Center over Thanksgiving weekend, and they got a pretty good field there, too. If they're able to beat Boise State, who's their first opponent, they could face Michigan State, who's the 13th-ranked team in the land. Arizona also in that. They're number 12 in the country. So they have an opportunity to add another elite high-major team to this schedule. Comes Jacko again to the free throw line.
You know, I talked to Scotty Brooks and Maj Track, two good friends of mine that are from down here. Scotty played here, and he had come to see some practices and had nothing but great things to say about Coach Turner, and I see why now.
74-49, 25-point lead for UC Irvine, who will improve to 2-0 on the young season. I'm remind you to stick around here on KDOC. KABC's Eyewitness News is next. Sopranicus for three, knocks it down.
Big time drive by Smith and kick.
Spears kicks it back out. It's Humphreys. They go inside to Jacko, who gets his put back to go.
Jacko's got that second bounce. Don't see from too many athletes at this level.
Jacko, he can play.
13 points for Jacko tonight. He's had a good showing. Seconds left in the shot clock, got a 20-second disparity between the shot clock and game clock. Likely last possession for UCI. Martin misses, good hustle by Ray, ends up in the hands of LMU. Jacko's two-point bucket good. He'll finish with 15 points tonight, and that will do it for us. 77-53 likely would be your final. We are now inside of 10 seconds. Just holding it around. Smith, ball comes out. Sopranik is gonna put it up late. He missed the shot. UC Irvine goes on to beat LMU 77-53. A nice display by the Anteaters tonight. And that's gonna do it for us. For Rob Abreu, Billy Bano, I'm Trent Schlum saying so long from the Bren Center in Irvine, California, where UC Irvine goes on to beat LMU 77-53. Stick around right here on KDOC. KABC's Eyewitness News is next.